Hi, everybody. I'm Phillip Goodman from the Druesedow Real Estate Group at Keller Williams Group 1, Inc. in Reno, Nevada. And I'm here today with Leslie Byrd, who is our Washoe Valley expert. Hi, Leslie.
Hi. Hi, everybody.
Last month, we took a pretty narrow look at what was happening in just the Washoe Lake area. But today, we're going to expand our coverage and look at what's happening in Washoe Valley, Virginia City.
Reno Foothills.
And the surrounding
areas.
Islands.
Yep.
Absolutely. So for that, let's go inside the MLS and look at the numbers for August of 2018.
Okay.
Last month, Leslie and I took a sharper focus at the Washoe Valley area. But this time, Leslie, we're going to take a look at some of these surrounding areas.
Right. Just sort of the whole swath of the agriculture and farm area there in the Washoe Valley, BC Highlands area.
And what separates VC Highlands from Virginia City?
So the VC Highlands is more to the west of Virginia City, and it's more the kind of lower mountainous terrain that sort of branches into the Reno area.
And you really need a good four-wheel drive vehicle and a bulldozer if you want to build properties out there, huh?
For many of those properties, that is correct, yes. It's more mountainous, it's more tree-covered, the roads are more rugged, there are some homes out there that are completely off-grid.
Leslie and I ran a search for the active listings and the sold listings for the month of August in 2018. Leslie, what happened in your neighborhood?
So there are 60 currently active listings, and then there were 10 sold in the month of August. You can see that the median, the average price is $820 for the active listings and $569, $570 for the sold listings. You can see that comparatively to Reno, in this area, we do have homes on the market a little bit longer, part of that being that our price range is a little bit higher.
The higher the price, typically the longer it stays on the market.
That is true, and there also is some uniqueness to the area, being that it is farm and agriculture, and that's, serves a smaller swath of the community.
Makes sense.
Yeah.
Now, one other caveat about these numbers is that these do not include any pending sales.
That is correct. There are about 18 other homes that are currently on the market that would skew the numbers if we were looking at just averages. We don't know what they're going to final out at, until they report on the market what their final purchase price is. So we don't include those in this data.
Leslie, let's take a look at the, look at this. Looks like one property just got posted
or
closed as we're talking about it. Live data here. So now we're looking at 11 properties that sold.
Yeah.
But we're seeing a variance between what was asked for and the actual selling price.
Yep. I mean, we're looking at folks are getting about 98% of their asking price. So there's a variance of, 1 to 2%. Really, it means the market is strong. I mean, if we're not doing a whole lot of price reduction, so we have enough buyers in the market to be able to satisfy the demands of the sellers. I mean, really. So it's showing that we're still in a good, strong seller's market.
So another indicator of the strength of the market is days on market. It took a few years for this $2.4 million property to sell. So that's going to skew the data here about the low, average, and mid.
Yep.
But we've got properties in the 30 to 60 day range, which is pretty typical.
Correct. And that's the whole factor from listing to close. So we got to consider there's the escrow time in there. So some of those are some pretty rapid sales. I mean, they were, maybe on the market for 10 days before they closed, depending on, how long their escrow was. So
well, there you have it. There's a broader look at what's happening in the Washoe and Pleasant Valley areas. Leslie, what's happening in your neighborhood this month?
The Genoa Candy Dance, the 29th and 30th of September. Super fun. Originally started in 1919 as a fundraiser, basically, to put streetlights in the town. It was such an amazing thing. They also did a midnight supper at the local hotel there. Actually, Carson City Barbecue is doing a dinner there this year for $32 a plate. Super amazing, tasty stuff. So
Carson City Barbecue was at the Nugget Rib Cook-Off, and they're good.
Yeah, super good. So yeah, Genoa Candy Dance is a blast. All kinds of fun, all kinds of great things to do. 2 days worth of fun stuff. So everybody should go out and check it out.
Excellent. Well, for more information about the Candy Dance, go to genoanevada.org. For more information about the market stats that Leslie and I have shared with you, you can contact Leslie at the information you see on your screen now. If you found this information helpful, please give it a like and a share on your social media as well. For Leslie Byrd, for the Druesedow Real Estate Group at Keller Williams Group 1, Inc. in Reno, Nevada, I'm Philip Goodman. We'll see you next time.